Are you sick and tired of gambling your hard-earned money on Madden packs? Well, look no further than my sponsor, MMOEXP, for the cheapest and the most reliable MUG coins on the market. And don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 5% off. The link for their website will be right at the top of the description. Are you looking to take your Madden game to the next level? Look no further than Civil.gg for the best ebooks on the market. Choose one of two membership options, and don't forget to use code FERDY at checkout for 25% off. What's going on, guys? Today is a very, very, very special day because we are looking at the brand new legend, Mike Vick, the first Mike Vick of Madden 22. Before we hop into it, though, if you are new here, hit that subscribe button. We are on the road to 30,000 subscribers. So the subscribe button, turn notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And I also will leave a link for my Twitch channel down in the description. We are live almost every single night over on Twitch. So if you haven't come through yet, I recommend you do. And the shout out for today's video goes to my man, Blake DeBoer. I almost probably can guarantee I said his name wrong, but shout out to my man Blake for commenting the emoji on last video. So here is the man himself, legend Mike Vick, and I think this Vick card is easily the best first Michael Vick that we've seen in a Madden in a minute. Like, this card is just ridiculous, and I'll tell you why. So it's not only because he has 92 speed, 92 acceleration, 94 agility. Obviously, Mike Vick gonna be a super elite ball carrier. I think he's probably, even though he's a quarterback, probably one of the best guys as a runner in this game. 85 carrying, you know, 93 ball carrier vision, 92 juke, 93 COD with a 92 break tackle and a 92 spin. So this dude can literally do everything, can break tackles, has elite speed in this game. I think that he actually might be the fastest card in the game, base-wise. I think he actually is. So that's what makes this card even more ridiculous. But I went back and I watched the first Mike Vick gameplay from Madden 21, and I'm pretty sure that card had like 83 or 82 mid-accuracy. And this card, they actually made him hit the threshold when he is fully powered up. So 89 mid, 90 deep, 87 short with that 92 throw on the run, 92 throw power, 89 throw under pressure, 92 play action, and an 88 break sack. And I feel like usually I like Mike Vick cards, but usually I don't keep them. I usually don't run them because of the accuracy and how like the balls come out lofty and stuff like that. But I feel like in this year's Madden, I am going to try one game with Escape Artist and one game with Pass Lead Elite. That is the plan today. But I don't feel like in Madden 22 next gen, at least, you really don't need Escape Artist, especially when you have a quarterback as fast as Vick. I feel like even when I had, you know, Fitzpatrick, or when I used Josh Allen, or when I used Zach Wilson, they were still escaping from linemen because of their speed and acceleration. And Mike Vick has 10 or I think 9 better speed than those guys that we've kind of been using that also have great velocity. But the reason why Vick's going to be so special is because he does come with Pass Lead Elite. So he is going to get those abilities that, you know, Aaron Rodgers gets, or, you know, Ryan Fitzpatrick gets. So you can actually add velocity to his passes if that is kind of a complaint for you. So this Mike Vick card is kind of for everyone. I feel like in previous Maddens, you know, you kind of need that gunslinger sometimes, that added velocity. But yeah, Mike Vick should be able to escape pretty well. I'm telling you, Escape Artist is going to be stupid on this card. I will say that. So if you're used to using Escape Artist, then I guess rock with it. But the fact that you can run Pass Lead Elite on this card if you want to, and obviously you can run Escape Artist too. Unfortunately, no, you cannot run both. Obviously, that would be what I would do. But you kind of got to choose depending on your play style. Yeah, do you want Pass Lead, the added velocity on your bullet passes, or do you want to be able just to go crazy behind the line of scrimmage and just swerve dudes and go crazy? I think this card is going to play fine even without Escape Artist, but like I said, I am going to try both today. Probably going to use Escape Artist first, though. But I mean, here's the Mike Vick that we're using today in today's gameplay. Mike Vick on a 25 out of 50 theme team, and yeah, he cleaned me out, man. My pockets and my coin count for sure. So, Mike Vick, hopefully you're worth it, man. But this card is just ridiculous, man. All around, I'm so excited for this gameplay. Let's do it. All right, so here we go, loading into game number one. And I do want to try this gameplay and house rules today. I feel like we're going to get more variety. And we're starting off on offense with Mike Vick. We're already into it. No kickoff, no top threes. We're just out here going crazy. So, let's see what Vick can do. I have Escape Artist on, like I said. So, the plan is I just want to show off that Escape Artist. Like, first things first, I'm going to put this on a nice little delay fade here, and we're going to double team the outside guy. And let's see what Vick can do, man, rolling out. There's Vick. You guys see the drip on the sleeves and the little wrist tape. And we're just going to try a rollout corner. It is the wrong way, I know it is, but we can still, you know, we should be able to still get that there. Mike Vick, there's that loft that I'm talking about. We do get a nice gain, though. But Escape Artist is just going to be ridiculous on this card, man. It's going to be crazy how good Escape Artist actually is. Like, you won't be, like, there's not a single card in this game, not even maybe a cornerback that'll be able to keep up with him. So, say a guy is sending some nickel pressure, like, Dude, you're not landing up the middle of the middle here with this. Oh my goodness, bro. This card is ridiculous, bro. And he's got a good spin. Oh no. Oh no. Get out, Vic. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. He's running out of stamina, obviously. Oh my god, bro. Yo, I think we actually got a gain on that. Bro, Escape Artist is nutty. I'm gonna call timeout. Like, oh, I actually don't have any timeouts. Okay, maybe I shouldn't have done that so much. But yeah, it's nutty, man. Escape Artist, you guys see like the speed that we're hitting? It feels like we have a golden ticket behind the line of scrimmage right now. It's just how it's feeling. Hit it outside there, Vic. Spin that. Okay, Jared Cook's spin is brutal. Good tackle by Ramsey. We kind of have to score this, but Vic has no energy, so it's going to be tough, actually, for us to punch this thing in. I'm not going to lie. Like, Vic with no energy, I think I kind of screwed myself here in this house rules, this first game at least, but yeah, I think it was worth it, honestly. I do. We're having a good time this morning, you know? We're having a great time here with Mike Vic. And we got to. And we're going to try to get, we're going to try to get Devontae Adams open here. That is the plan. And get it there, Vic. And nice RPO. And we're going to get swallowed behind the line of scrimmage. We should have A open. Get it there, Vic. And that's going to be a touchdown. Honestly, yeah, if he's these accuracy stats. You guys saw the first throw of the game on that corner route, which I rolled the wrong side. If I am going to keep Vic, it's going to take some time for me to get used to, you know, how he plays and how using a lefty quarterback works in this game. I'm just going to hit him out of the backfield. Should be a two-point conversion. And, nice first drive for Vic. I'm not even going to play defense. Let's just hop into another game. House rules game number two. And we are trying Escape Artist for one more game. And then I want to try pass lead for sure. But I want to show up some more pocket passes with this card with Escape Artist. I mean, most likely you're not going to be. You probably will basically never be in the pocket with Mike Vic, but if you ever are, I'm going to need to escape here from... Okay, that's the problem with Escape Artist in this game. I just said I wanted to pass him more, and that dude sent heavy pressure, Mike Vic down the sideline, and he fumbled out of the back of the end zone, I think. Touchback. Okay, so I guess the card can fumble. Let's do one more game with Escape Artist. All right, here we go. House rules game number three, and we're still rocking with Escape Artist. He's sending three at Vic. You can't do that. And there's that ball coming out. No pass lead elite. Still rocking with Escape Artist. And I think there is going to be a big difference between pass lead elite and not pass lead elite. But also, I wonder if it's as big of a difference between running Escape Artist and not running Escape Artist. That's what it kind of comes down to, I think, in my opinion. But, I mean, with Escape Artist, you guys saw in that last game, it is ridiculous how good it actually is. Can I run tight end ankle out of this? I cannot. Okay, so I guess we'll just stick with this play then. Push up a zone. If he wants to send more pressure, we will adjust. Still sending three. No spy either. Left B wide open again. Let's try throw another down here. Mike Vic, passing touchdown. And now let's hop into a game or a drive with pass lead elite and see how that feels. And while we are loading into this game, I do want to show you guys a pretty cool setup that I think that you guys can run if you are willing to invest some more AP into Vic. And that is basically just putting Roaming Deadeye in the first slot. I feel like Roaming Deadeye just makes too much sense on this card. So honestly, yeah, Roaming Deadeye in the first slot. And you can also run Quick Draw in the second slot, which will definitely speed up that release. And then you can kind of run whichever ability you want. If you want to run Pass Lead Elite or Escape Artist or maybe even Fearless, which would make no sense. But yeah, you kind of, I like that setup a little bit. It does, you are obviously spending one more AP, but Roaming in the first slot, Quick Draw for that sped up release when he is under pressure. With a high throw under pressure, there shouldn't be many inaccurates. And also, he shouldn't take any saps with Quick Draw. But yeah, and then also, yeah, you can run Pass Lead Elite or Escape Artist on Vic. But we are in the game, but it's like a nice delay of game here to get us started. But hey, here we go. Pass Lead Elite. Let's see what we can do with it, man. I'm ready. Let's go. So first and 30, not the ideal spot for us, but we are gonna try to get our crosser open and see if we can get a nice bullet pass lead, stuff like that. And we're gonna hit B actually. Good velocity on that football. Damn, we do get a first down there. I'm gonna go ahead and go down. I wanted to get to the other hash mark so I can roll out and make that throw. But yeah, pass lead elite feels good so far against the cover four. You just kind of do some random crossers. If you get him cross-eyed eventually, you know, you'll be able to make something happen. But let's go with a tight end crosser. And we'll go with like a motion slant, I think. I like that idea a lot. Not a motion slant, but something like this I like. If he wants to send pressure, I do want to see how that Escape Artist feels. Actually, we can try it right now. So I want to I want to see a guy get through. That's what I want. So we can kind of get away from him. I want to see a guy get through so we can run away from him. Okay, there's a guy right there. No Escape Artist, and there's Vic still getting away. So, I mean, you should still be able to. There's the spin right there. Spin that thing back. Yeah, the thing is they gave Vic a good spin move. So, like, And say that's the last guy, you can outspin that safety. And I think I already said this, but yeah, that's why it's scary that Vic has. That's why it's kind of scary that Vic has that ability and to be able to spin and really not fumble with really no consequence. Even though we did fumble in that one game, I was going for the aggressive dive for the touchdown, but we'll probably end up throwing a pick here, honestly. I feel like I could definitely see myself throwing a pick. We have Corey Davis in the game right now, so you know it's scary out here for us. And I'm going to try to... we should still have that dot. And that's a dot that only, I think, pocket passers should be able to throw with that kind of velocity. So, touchdown, Mike Vick. Let's go for two. I actually forgot to go for two in that last game. But it is what it is, man. It is what it is. All right, we're going to come out in I form. Try to get someone open here. Why is... Oh, Cook's not in the game because he has no stamina. Okay, that would make more sense. And we're going to just sit on... Oh, maybe we get X open. Good dot for Mike Vick. And two-point conversion is good. Let's hop into another game. And one thing I love about this house rules is how I really don't have to play defense. Like, I mean, I'm sure you guys are loving it too because you guys are here. You clicked on this video to watch Mike Vick. And I love that I don't have to play any defense, man. You guys can just kind of sit back, relax, and watch Mike Vick just perform out there, man. So that's why I'm liking house rules right now for these gameplays. I wish there was always a house rules like this. But unfortunately, that's just not how it works. We're just going to try to, we're going to put him on this, we're going to put him on a slant, and we're going to motion Devontae, and he should get good separation as long as we can get this playoff in time. Devontae's moving very slow, and he's usually rushing, and I'm going to roll out here. We're going to hit Devontae on the run. There's that bullet pass, velocity, man, and even, yeah, if you have roaming, I mean, I should have probably taken my finger off of the back button there, but if you have roaming Deadeye, and you have, you know, pass lead elite, like, you shouldn't miss many throws on the run with Mike Vick, who even, you know, has a very high throw on the run rating, which, like, I just can't believe how good of a passer they made this card. And even if you are, like, someone, like I said, who likes pocket passing quarterbacks and likes having that velocity, like, you have pass lead elite on this card, which is just ridiculous to me, man. It is crazy how, like, legitimately scary good this Mike Vick card actually is. It doesn't make sense how good EA actually made him. And I obviously cannot speak for current gen Madden. In last year's game, you kind of needed escape artists in order to really escape from, you know, even defensive linemen. I'm not sure if that changed this year. Maybe it did on current gen. I've only played one game on current gen, so I actually have no idea. But I am kind of missing conductor that Fitzpatrick had. But what I was gonna say is, like, bro, if you don't need to run escape artists, like, you're still rolling out and you're still making these crazy throws. Like, the velocity on that football, it doesn't make sense coming from a day one, or not day one, a first Mike Vick in Madden. Like, it doesn't make sense at all. That's why, like, this card is just, like, I actually don't believe it. I know I keep repeating myself, but I literally just cannot believe it. All right, I would like to kind of run this thing in. If we can't, it's okay, but we're going to try to get away from Youngblood, and there's that speed. We're getting away from him, and we should punch this with Mike Vick, so... Like, you can get away from linemen without it. Like, you definitely can, as you guys saw right there. Youngblood isn't particularly slow either for an end. But, obviously, I feel like with escape artists, we're out of that pocket with ease. But you guys see, we're fine without it. So, like I said, I think it just comes down to what you want, what your play style is, which I just love about this card. He's for everyone. All right, guys, so that is going to do it for the Legend Mike Vick gameplay, and I don't need to say much about this card. What needed to be said was said in the video. So, yeah, Mike Vick, definitely a card I recommend. Card's a monster. Easily the best first Mike Vick that we've seen that I can remember in a Madden, and, yeah, this card's a passer, a runner, obviously. His fastest card in the game. He's worth it. He's the real deal. But one thing I noticed from when I hit record to start this video till now, Mike Vick, his price spiked, and I'm not sure why his price spiked. I completed his set for probably around like 850, but now, I mean, it's coming down a little bit now, but it spiked up to a million for some reason. I'm not sure why it did that, but from when I hit record, after I got my Mike Vick and did the sets and stuff, like, I bought this card, his 90 collectible, for around like 500k, and now he's 580. I bought this one for like 170, now he's 250. I'm not sure what happened from when I hit record to now, but for whatever reason, Mike Vick's price just shot up. It makes sense. This card is ridiculous, and, like, he's amazing, obviously. But, damn, I don't know. A million coins for this card, I don't think many cards are worth a million. I don't know if many cards are worth that. I'll probably still rock with Vick, though, because I already kind of have him. But I don't know. If you somehow pull this card, maybe sell him for now. I mean, his price will inevitably drop, right? I mean, if you want to use him now, use him. But it's weird how his price spiked. I don't know. I mean, I have no idea. But yeah, if you are still watching, let's comment the joystick emoji. Let's comment the joystick emoji for a chance to be shouted out in the next video. And if you are new here, hit that subscribe button, turn on the notifications. We post daily Madden 22 content. And as always, I will see you boys in the next one.